Hi guys, Grooving DJ here. Now, in this video, I'm going to be taking a look at alternatives to using G-clamps to hang your DJ lights on your T-bar or your overhead deck stand. This G-clamp here is typical of the sort of thing that a DJ will use. This bolt at the bottom attaches to your light. There's normally a bracket on the light and that bolts to there, and then this top part here in this section, this goes over the T-bar on the lighting stand, and then you tighten this screw here to secure it and stop it from moving about. Now this particular one from top to bottom is around 5 inches in size. Okay, so when you're using this clamp, you've got that attached to the T-bar. This piece goes over the top. Between the top and the bottom, you're losing 5 inches of height from your T-bar by using this clamp. So if your T-bar is like 6-7 feet in the air, you're immediately losing 5 inches by hanging your light using one of these G-clamps. So by the time you've actually attached that to your light fixture, which has typically got a bracket on like this, you're looking at losing maybe 8-9 inches in height. If your T-bar's up here, your light is going to be maybe 9 inches lower than the T-bar. So you're losing potentially a lot of height. Whereas if you use another method of attaching these things, then you can regain that height. And the method that I've started using recently is over here. Now this thing is called a super clamp, and it's made by a manufacturer called Manfrotto, M-A-N-F-R-O-T-T-O, and they make a lot of lighting equipment, stands, clamps, things like that for photographers and videographers and so on. But these clamps are very useful for the DJ as well, because underneath they have a hole just there where my thumb is, into which you can fit one of these guys. Now the piece at the bottom there where the wing nut is, that would be where you attach the bracket to your light, and this top part simply clicks in to the hole at the bottom. There's a pin on the side here which is spring-loaded, and that releases a mechanism inside. You might be able to see it moving there. There we go. That releases the mechanism, which then enables you to fit that inside. That is then secure. Once this button is popped out, that's secure, and you just safety check it. You can just turn this screw to tighten it even more to make sure that it doesn't wobble, and to ensure that it doesn't fall out if this gets pressed for any reason. So that's a secondary safety thing. That tightens up and then your light is secure. Now this top part is spring loaded, so that can accommodate fairly big bars. It can do small bars, and it can open a lot wider than that as well to accommodate really big bars. This part here, this is a plastic insert. At the moment it's fitted, so that will clamp onto a square section bar quite easily. But this comes out, excuse me while I... one hand, it's difficult. That actually comes out. There we go, that's out now. And it gives you a V-section, which is coated with rubber, so that grips. There's also rubber on this top section, and that will clamp then on a round bar. This plastic insert, there's a small groove there, and that actually fits over the top of this the other way around. Whee! That actually fits just in there when this is loosened off, and that will stay sitting in there. So that's safe in there. Now, I've actually got one on a stand over here, so we'll go and see that. Okay, now here is your typical T-bar with one of these Manfrotto Super Clamps mounted on it. It's all tightened up, so there we are. As you can see, there's very little distance between the bar and the bottom of the clamp. It's around an inch, I would say. So when you've got your light fitting secured to this little sprocket, then as soon as you insert that into the hole and press the clip, that's in. You can tighten it by the knob on the back, and then your light is right up flush with the bottom of that clamp, and you're only losing an inch of height between the T-bar and your light. And also it's very quick to release your lights when you've finished for the evening. That just pops out. There we go, your light's out. So quick to fix, quick to release, and saves a lot of space. And these are very neat and tidy as well. Very unobtrusive, and they go nicely on a typical T-bar. Okay, so there we have the DJ light fitting, which in this case is a OptiKinetics Solar 250, and the little sprocket, widget, whatever you want to call it, is now attached to the top by using the threaded section and the wing nut underneath. So that's now secure, and that can even stay on the light even when you put the light away in your box at the end of the evening, because it doesn't take up much room, whereas one of these guys takes up a huge amount of room. And usually if you use this and you leave it attached to your light, you won't be able to get your light back in the box. You'll have to detach this every time you put your light away and reattach it again when you do your next gig, which is inconvenient to say the least, because if you're attaching this to every light when you're setting up for a gig, this takes maybe 1 minute to attach to the light. If you've got, say, 10 light fittings and you're attaching one of these G-clamps to every light before you can hang it, you're losing 10 minutes of time simply by attaching G-clamps to your lights before every gig. So if you use these guys and leave them attached, it's only around an inch. You can leave that attached to your lights when you put them away in the box. You don't need to take them off. When you're ready to attach your light at the gig, you can simply take your light, offer it up to the light fitting there, which I can't do with one hand, and attach it. Okay, so there you have your light fitting with the little sprocket attached to the bracket on the light, and that is now clamped into the Manfrotto Super Clamp and secured for the evening. So that's not going anywhere. Even if someone was to press the release mechanism on the side, the screw at the back prevents it from actually dropping out, and you would also put a safety wire through this bracket and over the T-bar so that if anything did happen to the clamp, then the light wouldn't fall off. So there we go. That's a space-saving method of hanging your lights for the 2007 DJ. Practice and enjoy.